you're thinking, how in the world did my Gmail get hacked? I had passkeys, I had two-factor authentication, I had a super strong, unique password, but still a hacker was able to get in. Or maybe you didn't use any of these measures and your Gmail got hacked. Well, no matter what the case, do not worry, because in this video, I'm gonna show you step-by-step the two best options for getting a hacked Gmail account back. If you like this content, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and also share it with anyone who is struggling with a hacked Gmail account, because I know there are tons of people. Okay, so first things first, run an antivirus scan. Before we get to recovering our Gmail, this is very important. Windows Defender, Malwarebytes, there are tons of great antiviruses out there. Honestly, you can just use Windows Defender or Mac's Security Antivirus as well. Both work just fine. And figure out if there's malware on your device. If you see anything suspicious after running this scan, delete it. Now, if you are confused on how to run antivirus, if you are just plain worried that there is something on your laptop, you can always bring your computer to a local PC store. After that, let's get to option one. This is trying Google's recovery process. This method is obviously the most obvious one and the easiest one to access. Now, if you've already tried this method and it's not cutting it for you, don't worry, I have a second option later in this video. But I do have some important tips for this recovery process if you're still willing to try it, and you should, because you should be doing two of these options slash methods that I'm gonna mention in this video at the same time, so you have the best chance of recovering your hacked Gmail account. So Google's Gmail recovery. Go into Google's page and try to log in. Type in your email. Say you can't log in. Choose how to log in. Now, depending on which contact methods you currently have access to, which ones the hacker has changed, result in how easy it is to get your account back will vary. Now, I am not going to walk you step by step on exactly what is gonna happen when you put in your email, when you put in your phone number, because just like with every social media recovery process that I explain in my videos, all of them are different depending upon which information you have, which device you're using, what time of day that you're logging into your account. There are so many factors that go into what you're seeing. But regardless, there are two tips that I've seen have been the most successful for people trying this method. Number one is recovering your Gmail account from a known device. Please use a device that you previously logged onto Gmail with. So whether that's your computer, your mobile device, your nephew's MacBook that you logged on a few weeks ago, use that device to try to recover your account. Because if Google sees that you are logging on from a known device, there's a better chance that you're able to prove your identity and that you are the owner of your account. Tip number two, logging in from a known location. So if Google recognizes your IP address, like your home's Wi-Fi or your work's Wi-Fi, where you've logged onto Gmail in the past, this helps to confirm that you are the rightful owner. Try using a device and a location that you've successfully logged in on before. Try this method, see if Google gets back to you. Let's try option two. This is what I've seen has worked for a lot of people. And this is reaching out to Team YouTube on X, which is formerly Twitter. Hey, Team YouTube, I'm having some trouble with my Gmail. Would you be able to assist? Something like that. Now, Team YouTube is going to get back to you with a form. Now, you're gonna have a section where it's gonna ask you for information. It is really important to provide as much information as you can in this box. For example, my iPhone. I have the Gmail app on my iPhone and I typically access my Gmail on my phone. So what I would do is find the IP address of my iPhone. I am typically connected to Wi-Fi. So what I would do is go on to my settings, go to Wi-Fi, click that icon button, and find my IP address there. You could also go to your settings and find your IP address that way as well, or if you're not connected to Wi-Fi. Now on your laptop, you can literally just Google what is my IP address. Also include the email that you use to sign up for your Gmail. But let's just say that this was a different email from the one that you currently have, or the hacker changed it. You wanna include the original email address. Also include the phone number that's associated to your Gmail account. Any times that you've changed your password. How many emails you think you have on your Gmail? The person that you most often email on your Gmail. Any places that you have used single sign-on to using your Google account. Let's just say, for example, you log on to a shopping website and it asks if you wanted to sign on via Google and you did that via Google. Put that shopping page in the description box as well. Just put in as much information as you can to prove that you're the owner of your account. Now, wait for a response from Team YouTube slash Gmail. Make sure you put an email in there that's not currently hacked so they can contact you. So after you get back into your account, make sure you add a new phone number and a new recovery email. Set up a passkey. passkeys are really simple and secure alternatives to passwords. I would also recommend enabling an authenticator, like Google Authenticator or Authy. And of course, constantly review those devices that are connected to your Gmail account for any suspicious activity or any device that you don't recognize. Okay, guys, those are all the tips and tricks that I have today. I hope these options were helpful and these tips that I provided and you're able to get back into your Gmail account. If you have any questions, please leave them down below. You can also message me on Instagram, but I cannot always respond to everyone who messages me. I do try to get back to as many people as I can, but I try to always check the comment sections down in my videos. So I hope you all stay well. I wish you the best of luck, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.